to his disciples, "As the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. I have said these things to you, so that my joy may be in you, and that your joy may be complete. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I do not call you servants any longer, because the servant does not know what the master is doing. But I have called you friends, because I have made known to you everything that I have heard from my Father. You did not choose me, but I chose you, and I appointed you to go and bear fruit, fruit that will last, so that the Father will give you whatever you ask in my name. I am giving you these commands so that you may love one another." This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you.
Salvation of the world as he laid down his life for his friends. generously given himself to himself in the communion of love between Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. God's very existence, his identity, is the one who loves. The world was made out of this life-giving and transformative love, not from any lack, but so that God's love might have a new object, so that there might be others who can choose to answer that love and generosity. What John impresses upon us time and again is that love is at the heart of reality. Love is the most real thing there is. Little children, love one another. It is the Lord's commandment, and if it alone is kept, it is sufficient. Love is sufficient because it is from God. Throughout history, there have been many strategies to make religious systems succeed. Charismatic fervour, hierarchical authority, liberal egalitarianism, collaboration with the state and military power. At one time or another, the church has experimented with all of them. But they are not God's ways. Whatever apparent successes they can produce, they are not fruit that shall last. The only way in which the church can flourish and be fruitful, as Christ promises in today's gospel, is in the way of Christ and his cross. It is only love that can change and transform human hearts. We hear a lot of talk from church growth experts these days about various strategies and plans. Much of it merely mirrors the anxieties we see in other sectors of society where traditional patterns of belonging are in decline. I was struck yesterday reading the newspapers, for example, that much of what we talk about in the church is similar to what certain political parties are saying who might not be getting the results they want. We are told that we need different leadership or a different message. We need to engage better with young people or those in everyday work. We should listen to what people want and change our offer in light of that. But things should be different in the church. We are not an organisation or club like any other. The church here upon the earth is that outermost part of the great communion of saints which stretches across time and space, known as the body of Christ. The church is that place within the world that embodies, that incarnates the mystery of love at the heart of reality. Little children, love one another. God is love. God has made all things out of love. Out of his great love for the world, God has sent his Son to redeem the world. And by his Spirit of love, he is drawing all things into the completion and communion of his love. As Jesus says elsewhere in John's Gospel, by this all people will know that you are my disciples, if you have love for one another. It is the Lord's commandment. If it alone is kept, it is sufficient. Maybe the real hope of the church lies in our loving prayer and service for one another, our works of mercy towards the poor and the sick, in the radical offer of forgiveness we embrace for ourselves and for our neighbour, however much they may irk us. As the church year begins to shift towards Christ's ascension, in which his sacrifice of himself upon the cross was offered in the heavenly temple, and the subsequent sending of his Spirit at Pentecost, which strengthened his disciples to go out into the ends of the earth and proclaim the gospel of Christ, we need only remember one thing as we seek the flourishing and fruitfulness of the church in our own time. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. If we love one another as Christ has loved us, then the world will know truly that we are his disciples. We can be sure of this because Christ has promised it, and he happens to know a thing or two about it.
Let us declare our faith in God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified and upon his side. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will not end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
Amen.
In the power of the Spirit and in union with Christ, let us pray.
Loved them from the beginning. We pray for Eric Nash and John Barwick.
It is the start of Christian Aid Week tomorrow, and on your seats you will have had one of these envelopes left, and I encourage you to take it home with you, please, and then bring it back, preferably with some money in it, next week if you come. Or if you're not able to join us again, then send it to where the details are on the form. It is good for us to support parts of the world that are in incredibly difficult conditions of poverty.
Amen.
You'll also see on your seats one of these sheets. You'll have seen that it's the start, it's Ascension Day on Thursday. We have a service here at 7 o'clock, and I would encourage you to come to that service. It is one of the major feasts of the churches here, a forgotten feast in many ways. We shall be here worshipping at 7 o'clock, and it would be good if you're able to join us for that. And this sheet is to help us through the period between Ascension Day and Pentecost. And we're praying for thy kingdom come, that line in the Lord's Prayer. And there are some resources here to help you in that prayer. And as we pray for the world, certainly, but also pray for thy kingdom come within our own diocese, and to pray for the growth of the church within the diocese at this time. So I would encourage you to use that facility, please. You will see that we have changed some of the services on our Zoom, in that we are now no longer doing evening prayer on Tuesday and morning prayer on Thursday, but we are starting morning prayer on a Wednesday. And we've done that because we are now offering services here at the Minster on the Tuesday and the Thursday. And therefore, if you are able to come during the week, it would be good to see you. There are a loyal group of people who do come, but it is open for everybody. Sunday isn't the only day where we worship God, and there are places here on Tuesday and Thursday also where you can come and share in the communion services that we offer here. There are a number of other things of importance on this notice sheet, so do please take it home with you, have a look at it, and engage with some of the things that it refers to. Now we're going to publish some bans of marriage. I publish the bans of marriage between Ryan John O'Dwyer, single, of the parish of St. Cuthbert and All Saints, Acton, and Katie Marie Cheatham, single, of the parish of St. Cuthbert and All Saints, Acton, with a qualifying connection to this church. And between Adam Lee Wilkinson, single, of this parish, and Demi Louise Gregory, single, of the parish of St. Luke's, Rossington. This is the second time of asking. If any of you know any reason in law why they will not marry each other, you are to declare it now. We do pray for God's blessing upon Ryan and Katie, who are here today, and Adam and Demi too, and for all others who are preparing for married life together, and we pray for God's blessing upon their marriages.
celebrate with joyful hearts the memory of your wonderful works. For by the mystery of his passion, Jesus Christ, your risen Son, has conquered the powers of death and hell, and restored in men and women the image of your glory. He has placed them once more in paradise, and opened to them the gate of life eternal. And so in the joy of this Passover, earth and heaven resound with gladness, while angels and archangels and the powers of all creation sing forever the hymn of your glory.
Great is the mystery of faith.
Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again.
And so, Father, calling to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice did once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people, and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we in the company of the Blessed Virgin Mary, St. George, and all the saints may praise
Jesus Christ, our Lord,
by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
Let us pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Amen.
We bring this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. his sight, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you, and remain with you always.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Alleluia.